Some KiwiBuild homes are proving slow to sell, even in our largest city. The Otahuhu apartments have been on the market for months, but just one of 10 has been bought. The latest figures have seen concerns raised again over the government's flagship policy. For more, Infometrics chief forecaster Gareth Kiernan joins me now from Wellington. OK, Gareth, the latest figures, only one in 10, about 30 minutes away from Auckland at the moment, from Auckland City. Are alarm bells ringing?
Yeah, I think when you look at KiwiBuild, if there was one place you'd expect the government to be able to sell properties, it would be in Auckland. So the fact that these are not selling does really cause concern.
What's the problem?
Well, in my view, there's two issues. One is that the government is building stuff or buying stuff that people don't necessarily want to buy. And then it's probably a case of the price as well. I mean, $650,000, it might be cheap for, or, you know, relatively cheap for some parts of Auckland. But for many first home buyers, that still is a big stretch. And so to call it affordable is difficult.
Yeah, would you say that they're a good deal for a first home buyer?
Look, it does depend on location. It does depend on the sort of facilities and the apartments, you know, the buildings that you are offering up there. But I'd say, given the slowing market in Auckland and the fact that they are not able to sell these at the moment, you'd struggle to call them a good steal.
Some developers are saying there's too many hurdles to buy. Would you agree with that?
Look, I think given the undersupply of housing in Auckland and the affordability crisis that we've got, those hurdles shouldn't be too much for people. You know, if you are really desperate and wanting to get into the housing market, and we've had a lot of stories and a lot of rhetoric from the government around this, then I don't see those hurdles as being something that would stop people getting in there. So I think there's bigger issues at play here.
OK, what are those issues?
Well, like I said, I think it's the government building stuff in places where people don't necessarily want to buy it in some cases. And you look at Wanaka, for example, to Kowhata, there'll probably be problems in New Plymouth with the development that they're looking to go ahead with there as well in terms of getting those sold. And then it is a case of, you know, what is the actual price that people are willing and able to pay for the property?
What happens if they can't sell them, if they don't sell?
Yeah, well, the government's set aside about $2 billion for the KiwiBuild program, and the idea was that they would roll that money over every couple of years and cycle through properties as they built them and then sold them off. If they're unable to sell them, then they're going to have a lot of capital tied up. It's going to cause issues in terms of a future build and the progress they can make there as well. And ultimately, you know, the taxpayers left sitting with a whole lot of properties potentially that no one's willing to buy, at least not at the price the government has counted on.
Is there a better way? What should they be doing now?
Well, I think, you know, with KiwiBuild, you need to go back to the drawing board, because I don't think the government actually understands what it's trying to achieve with the policy. They've talked a lot about housing affordability, but at the moment, the way the policy has been structured and the way it's working, it seems to be helping a very select few people into their first house. And there are bigger issues at play, and I don't think Phil Twyford, as the Minister of Housing, fully understands, you know, why those affordability issues have arisen over the last decade. I mean, one of the big sort of, I guess, pushes with KiwiBuild was to try and increase the supply of housing as being one of the problems. And so far, all he's been doing is walking down the street, finding a house that's already being built and putting a KiwiBuild sticker on it. And clearly, that's not answering the problems that we're facing here.
And Gareth, if they go down the same track, do you think KiwiBuild is destined for failure?
Yeah, look, I mean, if you're struggling to sell the properties, like I said, you're not going to be able to roll the money over. You know, at the moment, we've built 70-odd houses and another 300 under construction. We're well behind the initial targets that the government set. And if you're not able to sell, you know, 40 out of 70 houses that you've built, there's no way on earth you're going to be able to sell 10,000 a year, which is their ultimate goal.
Thanks so much for your insight. Gareth Kiernan from Infometrics.